So the next match on court is the women's doubles final, an all-Chinese affair. Cheng Shu and Zhao Yunlei up against Zhang Yawen and Zhao Tingting.
And now the finalists from China, Cheng Shu and Zhao Yunlei. Also from China, Zhang Yawen and Zhao Tingting.
Women's doubles being an all-China final means China will win the title for the 12th time in the last 14 years.
So all-Chinese women's doubles final. China so dominant in this discipline. Three of the four semi-finalists were from China. Cheng Shu and Zhao Yunlei really have come to the fore since joining the world tour after the Olympic Games last year. Really seen them previously, although the first time I ever saw them was very impressed with them indeed, was at the Austrian International event in 2007, which they duly won. Now, as far as these two players in the red shirts, they are vastly experienced. Zhao Tingting and Zhang Yawen. Zhang Yawen, of course, is a former champion here in the women's doubles. 2 years ago, playing with Wei Yili. And Zhao Tingting was runner-up here at the All England Championship, defeated finalists again with Wei Yili, but that was back in 2005. So looking at their path through to today's final, and what we've really got to draw attention to is that semi-final against the number four seeds, the reigning Olympic champions. Du Jing and Yu Yang dropped the opening game 16-21, but came back with the symmetry in the score. An hour and 11 minutes, that semi-final. Very, very hard battle. But talking of hard battles, their opponents have had to battle in the last of their two matches. There we have Cheng Shu and Zhao Yunlei. Quarter-final victory over the number one seeds. And as I say, since coming really to the World Tour, really have got more and more impressive. So they've already beaten three seeded pairs, so they're unseeded themselves. Irrawaddy and Johari of Indonesia in the first round, and then the quarterfinal against the number one seeds, Chen Wensing and Qian Yuqin of Chinese Taipei. And then that semi-final against the Koreans, the number five seeds, Ha Jung-un and Kim Min-jung. Again, dropping the opening game. But when they really started playing the World Tour after the Olympic Games, won three tournaments back-to-back. Japan Open, China Masters Super Series event, and the Macau Open. Three tournaments in 3 weeks. And followed that up with defeated finalists at the Hong Kong Open, the last of the 12 Super Series tournaments for 2008. 22 years of age, Zhao Yunlei, Cheng Shu, 21. Zhang Yawen, 25. But she'll be 26 tomorrow. Zhao Tingting already 26. Seeded 7, but a world ranking of 30. And the reason they've only got a world ranking of 30 is because they've only got 3 tournaments to their names in this partnership in the last 12 months. And the 3 tournaments, they won 2 of them, the China Open and the Hong Kong Open. Semi-final of the French as well. So for this pair, the youngsters from China, winners of the German Open last week. Well, 2 Chinese pairs just emphasizing the strength and depth of China in this particular discipline. The women's doubles, 3 of the 4 semi-finalists from China. Wolfgang Orlund from France is our umpire. Malcolm Banham, the service judge from England.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Jonix All England Open Badminton Championships Women's Doubles Final between, on my right, Chen Xu, Zhao Junlei, China.
Only joined the World Tour the second half of last year.
On my left, Zhao Tingting, Zhang Yawen, China.
Against the vastly experienced Zhang Yawen and Zhao Tingting.
Zhang Yawen to serve.
Zhang Yawen, of course, former winner here with Wei Yi Li 2 years ago.
Play.
This the 3rd final, All England final as far as Zhao Tingting is concerned. She's been beaten in the women's doubles final in 2005 and the mixed doubles final in 2003, and she'll be hoping it's 3rd time lucky. And no doubt her partner, Zhang Yawen, will be wanting an early birthday present. Turns 26 tomorrow. Now, these two pairs have met each other only once previously. And that was in the final of the Hong Kong Open, the last of the Super Series events last year. Oh, great interception from Zhang Yawen. Formerly actually known as Zhang Ya, but Ya in Mandarin means coming second. And therefore she, in the year 2000, changed her name from Ya to Ya Wen. And indeed, she has enjoyed more success since then. What a wise move. Expect many more of those long, long rallies. Both these pairs in their semi-finals lasting over an hour. For Cheng Shu and Zhao Unlei, an hour and 8 minutes to beat the Korean pair of Ha Jung-un and Kim Min-jung. And for this pair, Zhang Yawen and Zhao Tingting, an hour and 11 minutes to beat the reigning Olympic champions, their teammates Du Jing and Yu Yang. Ah. Yeah, good interception from Feng Yawen.
Five, luck.
Right now I see a line in this game that the situation that Zhang Yawen and Cao Jingting is in an offensive position more or less all the time. The young Chinese player is defending too much, not really getting themselves in the right position.
The younger pair, Chen Zhu and Zhao Yunlei, of course, arrived here in Birmingham in great form, having won the German Open last week. But this is not the ideal start for them. Already 6 points deficit. First real opportunities they've had to get on the attack. Paul Eric, I was mentioning the fact that Cheng Shu and Zhao Yunlei only started playing the World Tour the second half of last year. Now, it's just extraordinary that a pair of this quality has not really been exposed to World Badminton for such a long period of time. But presumably that's because the Chinese have so many, or certainly did prior to the Olympics, and a number of their doubles players have now retired, but they had so many world-class pairs that even a pair as good as this couldn't get in the team to even travel to the tournaments.
That's true, Jill. I mean, they have so many players. Bear in mind, if we compare China to England and to Denmark, we have one main center. In China, there are 60 centers where they actually are bringing up world-class players.
I appreciate the points, and you're absolutely right, because I mean the way that they develop the players in each province, but in the other disciplines the rest of the world are able to challenge China, but in the women's doubles for years China have basically dominated. There's been one or two Korean pairs that have been able to challenge, as indeed Lee and Lee last year winning the All England Championships. But why is it that the rest of the world can't make an impact on the women's doubles and China are so dominant in this particular discipline?
There's definitely one thing that I would say China is ahead of the pack, and that is their technical skill, their speed in the game, and their physical capabilities. If you add up those things, then definitely that is one of the reasons. That means that if you want to invest some time in this, you should invest a lot of time in order to bring up your level at the Chinese level. And then I must say, as far as I can see throughout the last decade, the skill of the ladies double is that the Chinese is a bit better than the rest of the world skill-wise. So in order to be there, you have to start very early. I mean, I'm thinking of starting up playing badminton on a regular basis at the age of 8-9 years old, and then slowly getting more and more hours into it, and that is very demanding. I doubt there's a lot of countries who really are doing that in Europe.
Very good point.
And apart from wanting to commit that sort of time and effort to sport at that young an age, socially it doesn't fit into our society really, because we encourage our youngsters, obviously the schooling, and encourage our youngsters to play more than one sport and to make that sort of investment in time towards badminton. You're absolutely right. I think you made a very, very pertinent point there. Well, I do think that maybe Zhao Yunlei and Cheng Zhu in the black kit are perhaps a little bit nervous. This is such a big occasion for them.
Oh.
Yeah, there's another sign of the nerves, 11, five, the error when not really under pressure. And a six-point advantage at the mid-game interval. And of course, because two pairs from the same country, coaching staff just leave the players to their own devices, work out their own tactics. Well, that's very understandable. You can't have national coaches showing favouritism towards one pair. Well, this all Chinese women's doubles final means China assured of this title, and it'll be the 12th time in 14 years that Chinese women's doubles pairs have won this All England Championship.
11-5, play.
11-5. Ting Ting. She's the one that made the error at the end of the rally.
6-11.
But they're a clear example. There's nothing wrong with the attacking play of any of these Chinese women's doubles players, but the reason we get such long rallies is because, of course, the quality of the defensive play. Absolutely solid. Now, certainly when we coach and talk advice to European pairs playing the Chinese, we always say try and slow the rallies down, mix up the pace. You've got to have the hard smashes, but it's the variation in pace that perhaps can break down the defensive play.
7.
But I don't really see much of a weakness in any of these four players defensively.
No, I mean, they are so strong, both pairs, and you're absolutely right. In order to maybe have a small chance, you really need to variate with your speed in the game against a pair like this. That is actually the only thing you can do. I can't see any Europeans right now being able to pick up that speed, pick up that offensive game and defensive game.
7.
Hey, you were telling me the other day about statistics that you've worked out back in Denmark about watching these top Chinese pairs playing each other, and the average match time is 57 minutes. In other words, this is the sort of physicality of this discipline. It really is very, very physical. Thank you. appreciating the quality of all four players on court. The final defensive shot from Cheng Shu. Kilometers an hour, about 140 miles an hour. Well, it's not surprising they need to take a quick gulp of liquid.
Eight, 12.
It's a hand signal to our partner. Well, the umpire just calling the tournament referee. I think Zhang Yawen has spotted a problem in the crowd here. Perhaps somebody with a perhaps some of our colleagues doing an interview courtside, maybe distracting the players. Keith Hawthorne, the tournament referee, sorting out the problem. And play can resume. 8-12 opening game.
8-12 play.
Defence once again from Zhao Wenlei. And a much shorter rally. Well, that previous rally, 96 shots. And a minute and 23 seconds for one rally. I told you this was physical. You see, you men's singles players didn't know how tough it was for us ladies' doubles players.
No, no comment still.
10-12.
Well, it's not surprising after that rally that the tempo has just dropped slightly. Good judgment. Shuttle going long of that back line.
13-10.
Oh, that's wild.
14-10.
Talking of the physicality, in all seriousness though, Paul Eric, I mean, we did a little study of the second round matches of all five disciplines, and actually the most physically demanding in time, in regard to the time on court, was women's singles, an average of 53 minutes, whereas men's singles was 37. Men's doubles the shortest at 29. That's all second round matches. So certainly the women's game, since the scoring changed, is a lot more physically demanding than it used to be.
So it's over.
It definitely is still. And also because now it's all equal. I mean, before it was the women's single was playing up till 11 points. And that is a big change. Maybe that's the reason. So in some occasions, I also do believe that the depth of the ladies' singles has become better, and that means that it will be longer and longer matches.
Yeah. Very good point, because I think back a few years in women's singles, 15, players, it was dominated by two or three top Chinese players, and nobody really got close, whereas now we've got a number of players from around the world that are challenging the whole time, including, of course, Tina Rasmussen, who will be contesting the women's singles final, next match on court. She, of course, is defending champion. Just long again.
16.
Yeah, I think in general terms there's probably just more unforced errors at the moment from Cheng Shu and Zhao Unlei. Brilliant. What a defensive shot. Zhao Unlei's defence so far has been extraordinary. Stepping into the shuttle, driving it across court.
12-17.
The crowd here at the National Indoor Arena doesn't know which pair to support. Now, sometimes the atmosphere gets a little flat when both pairs from the same country, but this is women's doubles of the very highest quality. Technically, this is superb. Time she missed, but it was a good return of serve, pushing the shuttle at her opponent. Oh, change of mind from the line judge. Initially indicated in, 19, but in the end made the correct decision. Yeah, good courage by the line judge, because sometimes a little afraid to change their minds, and we want the right decision. So 2 points away 19, from the opening 30. Game for the number 7 seeds. Chang Yuanwen and Zhao Tingting. Oh, that's superb. Zhao Tingting seeing the gap across court. Good 20, lunge forward. And drives it across court. And now 7 game points. Only needed the one. Oh my goodness, we had some grueling rallies in that opening game.
First game won by Zhang Jiawen, Zhao Tengting, 21-30.
Perfect way to end the opening game. The scoreline in just short of 24 minutes, 21-13. I think in all honesty, Zhang Jiawen and Zhao Tingting really deserved that opening game. They were far more positive, took the game to their opponents and dominated the net area, emphasised by the point that they made six net winners in that opening game and their opponents didn't make any.
Second game, level play.
So Zhang Jiawen gets the second game underway. That's long of the back line. Zhang Jiawen missing with the attempted interception there. She, of course, has twice been a world championship medalist in the mixed doubles event, playing with Shi Zhongbo, silver and a bronze medal. Notice that youngsters Chen Shu and Zhao Yunlei, although they are spending an awful lot of time defending, they're positive on defence. They look to drive the shuttle back, and the number of times that Zhao Yunlei has tried to turn the shuttle, very impressive. And I wonder whether the fact that their first appearance in the All England, they've never been to this tournament before, and here they are in the final, and maybe in that opening game, perhaps just a little overawed by the whole occasion.
You're absolutely right, Jill. One thing that I paid attention to was that to begin with, they were actually not really feeling comfortable. They came in, got a better defensive, but one thing that is quite interesting watching the ladies' doubles, it's about the footwork. It's always focusing on going towards the net. It's always in a good position, and then trying to be focusing on your body and your movement is towards the net, and that's very interesting.
It's landed in.
So it's over. 3-1.
Again, even looking awkward on the defence, but still having the control.
Oh. Service over, 2-3.
Incredible. Brilliant badminton.
3-4.
I think the other thing, picking up on your point about the footwork, is I'm watching the movement now more closely of all the players, and it's the movement off the shuttle that's very impressive as well. So even when one of the players is smashing from the back of the court, the net player is not standing still at the net. They're moving back and front, side to side, readjusting their positioning with the hope of intercepting the next shot. Lovely defence from Zhao Tingting. Yeah, looked to be caught, committed to her backhand defence and played the forehand, but played it brilliantly. The action speed of these players on the defence is just extraordinary. Oh, it's just wide, going for a really acute angle.
So it's over.
Perhaps a little over ambitious from Jiang Yawen. These are the sort of incidents, though, Paul Eric, that, you know, I saw that Cheng Shu and Zhao Yunlei were getting pushed further and further back in their defensive stance, and yet their opponents kept smashing at them. And that's the sort of time when they should have been playing the drop. Because as you move back in court on your defence, then you become vulnerable to that deceptive drop shot, surely.
You're absolutely right, Jill. And that is maybe the weakness of the Chinese system. The way they play is be as offensive as possible, try to just put as much power into your game, and then they're not really relying on their takeoff pace in the game, and therefore you see these things.
Yeah. Good play from Zhang Yawen.
7-4.
Zhang Yawen, of course, Olympic bronze medalist in Beijing with Wei Yili in the women's doubles. Long of the back line.
So it's over. 5-7.
good aggressive play from the unseeded combination.
6-7.
I have to say, I'd like to see them try and be more aggressive more often in this match. Too often, just content to defend.
Yeah, you're right about that. And one of the reasons I think is that Shengshu, which has a really good smash, hasn't really been in position where she can use it. They haven't really built it up to her on the back, and that's the reason that they haven't really been showing that good offensive game.
7.
Shengshu, of course, the youngest player on court, just 21 years of age. All level in this second game. Very, very good serve. Immediately looking for the third shot. Racket up ready. Crouching down low. Short, sharp movement of that racket head. And the hand signal taking a long time about that. Oops! Oh, and it's landed out.
Service over.
Well, they were in all sorts of trouble. They didn't mean to leave that. They just got in each other's way. They are, of course, a new partnership. The one that did the damage, and once again it was Zhao and Lei, her defensive play. But just to qualify my earlier comment about this is a new partnership as far as Zhang Yawen and Zhao Tingting is concerned, of course they did play together way back in 2001-2002, and then they were split and played with different partners, so they reformed their partnership and only played three tournaments together right at the end of last year. So this is the fourth tournament since getting back together again as a doubles pair. Yeah, that's nice.
Service over. 9-4.
It's a good return of serve. I think the youngsters now are beginning to return a lot better than they did in the opening game. Immediately putting pressure on their opponents. Goodness. perhaps changed her mind, but it means that the unseeded pair of Cheng Shu and Zhao Yunlei go to the mid-game interval with the one-point advantage. Goodness me, look at that. Zhang Yawen, in her partnership with Zhao Tingting, making 13 of the 15 winners. And I guess in a way, it's her quality and her background in mixed doubles that is probably serving her well seconds. Here in that she knows how to create openings and able to see the weaknesses when she's coming forward to the net. These really are wonderful pictures, aren't they, of the slow motion.
Play.
So 11-10, second game. Was dropped in.
Service over. 11 all.
Yeah, that's a bad misjudgment. Well, the idea was sound, trying to block the shuttle, but seemed to lunge with her left leg rather than with her right leg, and that's why a bit awkward. There's that hand signal that all the top Chinese doubles players are now using, just letting their partner know what serve they're going to use. Oh, that's clever. And once again, it's Zhang Yawen.
13-11.
She really has been superb. Three straight points. Just sense that maybe the more experienced players are just able to use that experience to apply the pressure at these crucial stages. Just opening up a three-point cushion here. Good judgment. Left.
15.
Zhao Tingting. And five straight points now since the mid-game interval. That's a good flick serve. Decided to leave it because she got herself all tangled up.
Well, 15.
Wouldn't have been able to play it anyway.
Oh.
channel attack.
Thank you, Silva.
By the number seven seeds hitting the shuttle in between 16. Their two opponents. First with the clear, and then two smashes. Narrows the angle of reply, confuses opponents who's supposed to take that one down the middle. Good play.
13-16.
Brilliant. She's been the outstanding player on court, no question in my mind. Zhang Yawen. Some way, I think, probably from finishing this second game. Indication of the length of the rallies. Having said that,
18
now,
13.
The number seven seeds just 3 points away from the title. Court and Zhao Tingting coming 19, forward to the net, really 30. Hunting the shuttle. Yeah! Now just 1 point away. Twice previously, she's lost all England finals at Zhao Tingting. Seven match points. Oof. Well, they were celebrating. But it's called long of that back line. And a smile from 14, Zhao Tingting.
20.
Nice play. Cheng Shu whipping the 15, shuttle, coming over 20. The top of it, playing it cross court. Good vision to see the gap. Still another five match points. That's real shame for such a quality women's doubles to end like that. But Zhang Yawen and Zhao Tingting, finally for Zhao Tingting, she's All England champion, 21-13, 21-15. Well, that really was a very disappointing way to end such a final. Yeah, clearly in. third time lucky for Zhao Tingting. Had to settle for second best twice previously. And finally, she will stand on top of the podium.
Ladies and gentlemen, the presentations for the 2009 Yonex All England Women's Doubles title. To make the presentations, we're delighted to have back with us John Havers, President of Badminton England, Nora Perry, MBE, Badminton England International Delegate, and Mr. Minoru Yoniyama, founder of the Yonex Company. I'd now like to ask Mr. John Havers to step forward to present the commemorative medal to umpire Wolfgang Lund from France. To his service judge, Martin Bannon from England. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2009 runners-up from China, Cheng Xu and Zhao Yunlei.
Cheng Xu and Zhao Yunlei. Well, their first appearance at the All England Championships. I'm sure we'll see a lot more of them. And I wouldn't be at all surprised if even next year they go one better than this. They have huge potential for tournament finals last year, winning three tournaments back to back.
Won
the German a week ago.
Women's doubles champions are from China, Zhang Yawen and Zhao Tingting.
Zhang Yawen regains the title that she won with Wei Yili 2 years ago. And for Zhao Tingting, finally, at her third attempt in an All England final, takes the title. Nora Perry, former All England champion and former world champion in the women's doubles, makes the presentation. And the checks from Mr. Yoniyama, founder and president of Yonex Company, our title sponsors, who of course have just signed their commitment to sponsoring the All England Championships for another 5 years. That will be 31 years of sponsorship.
Send an invitation to our winners for a lap of honour of the arena.